Final Cut Pro X is 64-bit and runs very fast on newer systems. It is also making good use of memory, processor and video card performance. So you need a fast computer to run it. Apple's hardware requirements for Final Cut Pro X include the following minimum computer configuration. Mac with Intel Core 2 Duo processor, 2GB RAM OpenCL compatible video card, 256MB VRAM, 1280x768 pixel resolution monitor, newest version of OS X or later and 2.4GB of free hard disk space. However, the minimum hardware requirement always means that this is the configuration in which the program still runs. Older, lower performance machines will, of course, run the program as well, if it matches what is listed above, but much slower. Especially when we are dealing with high definition video or doing rendering. In this case, the weaker machine will obviously be slow. There are a few solutions to make lower-end machines faster, without having to invest in a new and expensive computer or switch to another editor. Of course, the solution is to add more memory to this machine. For example, instead of the recommended 2GB, 4GB can significantly speed up the program. 8 or 16 even more. Another good solution is to use a proxy. In Properties section, under the Playback tab, you have the option of letting the program play low proxy files instead of the original high-definition content during playback. You just have to check the Use Proxy Media option. This will speed up the program when playing clips. If all the clips turn red, then there is nothing wrong with it, except that we forgot to specify when importing, that the program must create a low-resolution version of all the high-resolution clips. This can also be done later in the settings under the Import tab by enabling the Create Proxy Media option next to the Transcoding section. The low resolution version will be created at the time of import. If you have forgotten to turn this on and you have already imported the clip into the FCPX, a red error message will appear. If you right-click on it, select Transcode Media from the pop-up menu. Here you can tell the program to create the proxy immediately. In many cases, the program runs faster even if Final Cut Pro creates the most suitable format for it. For example, transcodes the file at import. You can also configure this by clicking on the clip in the import section or later. However, the FCPX may not allow the clip to be transcoded. The Create Optimized Media option cannot be checked. There are two reasons for this: either it is not necessary because the clip is already in the correct format, or the performance of our machine is too low to encode the files. Alternatively, delete files that FCPX uses temporarily and always rewrites. By the way, this is not only the case with Final Cut Pro. Removing the preference files can be a good solution if you have trouble running any program. Although this will not speed up the program, it will help you in cases where Final Cut Pro behaves strangely, quits frequently, etc. The preference files are found in the Finder in the User Library Preferences directory. By default, this library is hidden, so you need to apply a little trick to make the library folder visible. Open the terminal and type chflags no hidden users username library, then press enter. Within this folder we will find the COM, Apple, FinalKit, LS shared file list, plist, file and delete it. Final Cut Pro X will create this file every time it starts up. Good luck with editing.